नमस्कार, दिस इज विक्रम सिंह किरत सिंह चौहान। वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल। इन आवर प्रीवियस मॉड्यूल्स वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द स्टेट ऑफ रेस्ट ऑफ अ बॉडी एंड स्टेट ऑफ मोशन ऑफ अ बॉडी। देन वी हैड टेकन द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मोशन। Today we will study the relativeness of motion. Relativeness of motion is an interesting term. You have seen many times when you are standing on the platform, the train comes from your right to left. It comes and then leaves the station. It goes towards left. Now for you, the observer who is on the platform, the train is moving towards left. Consider another person who is standing exactly on the opposite side, on the other platform, like this. Then, for him, the train, instead of moving towards left, it will move towards right. Now the situation is same. There is no role of the train. It is just moving from one point to the other point. But since it is being observed from two different positions, two different locations, two different frames of reference, what happens? For observer A, the train is moving towards left side. For observer B, the train is moving towards right side. When we go in the train, when you travel in a train, all the passengers inside the train, inside the coach, they are at rest. You are at rest. The passengers with you are at rest. The entire coach is at rest. But suppose an observer is standing outside. For him, you are in the motion. Other passengers are also in motion. All the objects in the train, they are in motion. And the entire train is also in motion. Now, a body simultaneously it is at rest and simultaneously in motion cannot exist. Physics gives restriction to us. A body either at rest or it can be in motion. So this relative term, this relativity in motion is called as relativeness of motion. Or we can say that motion is a relative term. Let us take an example. I am standing here. Since I am not moving, I am at the state of rest. With respect to me, this board is at rest. Marker, all the objects which are standing, which are in the room, they are at rest. This room is at rest. This entire building is at rest. But if the motion, if all these things, they are observed from a distant position, say an astronaut goes in space and he observes this building from the space, or if an astronaut goes to the moon and he observes from there, then of course, The earth is rotating about its axis. The earth is, this is the earth, imagine that this is the earth. If the earth is rotating about its axis, all the objects, they are also rotating about the axis. Now, am I at rest? Am I in motion? This entire building, is it in motion? This is what? The term called relativeness of motion. A body at rest for one observer may not be in the state of rest. Or a body in motion for one observer may not be in the state of motion for another observer. This phenomenon this situation about motion is called as relativeness of motion. We can cite many examples for this. Passengers in a car or bus which is in motion, the bus or car is in motion, are at rest. They will be at rest for all those observers, all those passengers which are in the bus, in the car. But at the same time, if someone is observing the motion of the car or bus from outside, then the bus, the car, and the passenger in those vehicles, they will appear in motion for the observer. The building on the earth appears at rest. When observed from the earth only. But it appears in motion when observed from the moon. And we can give many examples of the same. In Hindi, they call it as Parvat Jaisa Adik, mountain is at rest, it is not going to shift his place. If observed from one point to the other point, we will say that Himalaya is at rest. Of course, when observed from the earth, it is at rest. But when observed from the moon, the earth, the Himalaya, and every object on the earth is in motion. So I hope you have understood the concept of relativity of motion. An object which is at rest for one body may appear in the motion for the other. Using the same principle, we can give many other examples. The assignment for you, a simple, short, sweet assignment for you, is that to write down 10 such examples where we can come across that for one body, for one observer, an object is at rest, and for the other observer, the same body, same object is in motion. I hope you understood the concept of relativity of motion. Motion is a relative term. I'll give you an example how this relativity plays an important role. You have to do only one simple activity. Observe my finger and try to identify in which direction it is rotated. I am rotating it clockwise. This is the rotation for me is clockwise. The motion of the object, the motion of the finger is clockwise for me. This is my frame of reference. This is the observer and this is the object. Can you quickly tell me in which direction you are observing the motion of the finger from your frame of reference? Yes, for me it is clockwise and for you it is anti-clockwise. There is no roll of the finger, the motion of the finger, it is just rotating, rotating in a particular sense. But since it is observed from two different locations, then the motion, the direction of motion is changing. For me it was clockwise, for you it is anti-clockwise, exactly opposite. Now I am rotating it anti-clockwise. What is the direction of motion for you now? Yes, when it is anti-clockwise for me, clockwise for you. This is what the thing is, beta. All of you must understand that how physics can play an important role in our life. There are situations, there are conditions in our lives where we have to think from both the sides. When a situation is there, you start to develop such type of thinking. You observe each and every aspect of the thing. If someone is doing a particular act, try to change the frame of reference. Go on the other side. Don't observe it from only one side. Change the frame of reference, you will, at least you will come to know, okay, in what way, in which way the act had taken place. This is what the beauty of physics is. It not only gives us the formulae, the phenomena, the theorems, the theories, principles and all, but it also teaches us to live the life. Live the life with the effective brain. So today, in this module, we will just talk about only this much part. In our next module, we will discuss about the concept of distance and displacement, then speed and velocity, which are the important terms to describe motion. So by the time, this is Vikram Sinha, Kiran Sinha Chauhan, takes your leave. Thank you.